The world's biggest wind turbine. While some part of the world was shaking slightly from the fear of the possible spread of the pandemic, some group of shrewd investors was busy. For the first 6 months of the year 2020, mindlessly sinking in a mouth-dropping $35 billion of their hard-earned money into a futuristic offshore wind project. Since these actions were taken by the investors, various similarly eco-friendly schemes have since started getting notable recognition. Hello guys, welcome back to your favorite YouTube channel. Right before we delve into the video for today, please take out some time to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the bell button to get a notification of all our latest videos. So, right this moment, wind power has evidently outshined most, if not all, of its cynics. And currently, the question surrounding this investment becomes, what kind of breathtaking new tech is all that money going into? Take a tour with us today as we take you for a whirl and show you around the world's biggest wind turbine. General Electric's all-new Haliad X is an excellent combination of function and form, if there ever was one in wind turbines. This amazing structure rises gracefully over some 260 meters above sea level. Interestingly, the turbine has just the required capacity to produce about 12 megawatts of energy with an exciting industry-leading 63% capacity factor above industry standard. If you are querying what all this means, then you should know that it simply assures that when this wind turbine is fully operational, it will be capable of giving out a mouth-dropping 67 gigawatt hours of power in a year. Now, that is about 45 times more than the most powerful and most efficient windmills you may have ever come across in the market today. And for those of you asking what capacity factor is, this is a metric attribute that compares how much energy a windmill, for instance, generates over a given period and then compared to the maximum or theoretical energy expected by the windmill over the same period. Yes, it is a mathematical measure simply employed to calculate or estimate the essential price in the weather variability. And also, it is a major factor in wind farm development. No doubt, in an ideal world, the wind blows nonstop for the length of about 20 years for the lifespan of the turbine. However, life isn't always as we estimate it to be. In actual practical terms, the amount of energy these machines would likely produce may nonetheless still be very impressive. This is so since it is estimated that a single Haliad X turbine in an offshore setting can generate sufficient power to supply to about 16,000 European families. Remarkably, a single full turn of the blades is said to generate over 13 megawatts of power, which personally is just amazing. A single full turn is sufficient to supply 2 full days of electricity to an average UK household. Another way of looking at the turbine's benefits is by studying the emission reduction. We do this because these windmills do not burn fossil fuels. Apparently, the clean energy these massive blades produce is the exact equivalent of taking 9,000 cars off the trail for an entire year, or 42,000 metric tons of carbon emissions right out of the atmosphere. Now, is that not simply amazing to say the least? Again, these calculations are just for a single turbine. Go on and do the calculation of having 2 or 3 of these amazing wind turbines up and running. No doubt, these investors will be doing something impressive for our world once the turbines become operational. Did we also mention the part that these turbines are very big? Well, for starters, you should know that each of these windmills is as tall as an 85-story building. Talk about turbines being as tall as some skyscrapers. And that's not all. Each of the 3 Haliad X's individual windmill blades is about 107 meters long. Wondering how long that is? Let's put the wingspan of an Airbus A380 into perspective. The wingspan of the Airbus is only about 80 meters, but here we are talking about 107 meters. Clearly, these windmills mean business, and it is not just some hollow clean energy flex. It actually makes sense from an engineering point of view. One thing is for sure, installing great forests of these monsters on the seabed won't be a small task. So, the rarer you need to install out there, the better and cheaper it is for everyone. Another impressive fact about these blades, whose tips are said to cover about 80 meters per second, is capable of covering a so-called swept area of over 38,000 square meters. In case you're not aware of how big that is, that's about the size of 7 American football fields, big thanks to how the area of the circle is calculated. The area is about double the length of the blades, and this means that the blades can multiply this all-important swept zone by a factor of 4. The prototype proof of the Haliad X is presently standing proudly at Maasvlakte in the Dutch port of Rotterdam. and is an inspiring glimpse into what the future would look like. Nonetheless, to get a foresight of how this wind turbine would work, we can take a look at the operation and application of the recent $10 billion Bank Wind Farm that is currently being developed to serve the United Kingdom market. This $10 billion wind farm is situated 160 kilometers off the Yorkshire coast, out in the North Sea. Dogger Bank is expected to operate in three stages. Stages A and C will collectively generate 2,400 megawatts from a remarkable 190 Haliet X 13 megawatt offshore turbines, scheduled to deliver their first power to the grid as early as 2023. Once the Dogger Bank will become fully operational around 2026, it will supply around 6 million United Kingdom homes, the equivalent of 5% of the whole country's energy consumption. Amazingly, the final confirmation order for those 190 Haliet X turbines got delivered successfully on GE's desk the same day GE proclaimed it would no more be supplying power equipment to new coal-fired power plants. Apparently, the green energy future is presently here. Offshore wind projects around the world are now queuing up to experience GE's forthcoming kickoff. Energy giant Ørsted recently declared that they would be employing the turbine in two of its schemes off the east coast of the United States. Vattenfall, a Swedish utility farm, has come forward with the prospective use of the Haliet X turbine on its Baltic and North Sea farms. Also, in Brazil, the upcoming 702-megawatt Asa Branch project would most likely be making use of the turbine as well. Interestingly, China, where wind energy is an even bigger deal than in the United States, has a dedicated GE factory on construction. The factory is being built solely to serve the key Asia-Pacific turbine market. It is great news that these orders are coming in because having this turbine set up was a huge task for GE. The report has it that the project sunk about $400 million of the firm into the investment scheme. The essential safety certification, which demonstrates they're worthy of real-world deployment, was only issued in November 2020 following very detailed testing of the 12-megawatt Rotterdam prototype. These prototypes had separate blades conveyed to both the United Kingdom's offshore renewable energy in Blyth, Northumberland, and the Massachusetts Wind Technology Testing Center in Boston. As you may have guessed, with such record-breaking blades, transporting and mounting them was a challenging task in itself. Expressly built facilities were raised to do the job in Cherbourg, France, since it couldn't be carried out by the regular transporting firms. Actually, these blades were the very first wind turbine blades ever to exceed 100 meters in length. The blades were also 4 meters round at the root and were largely made from fiberglass. They were also cleverly engineered with a deliberate bend in order to avert the blades from flexing and striking the tower on breezy days. With the arrival of the pandemic, a new wave challenge came up as well. The pandemic presented its own challenges to the process, with the chief architects of the project forbidden to go to Blyth for the final static tests. Other innovations are also being tried for the first time on Haliet, many of its onboard diagnostic systems presently working remotely. This is to duck some costly and dangerous seaborne maintenance tasks, which can be really precarious on the North Sea. The engineering team also created a brand new compact type of switchgear for the project. In case you have no idea, the switchgear is similar to a fuse box in your house, just that this is on a much grander scale. The switchgear helps energy flow effortlessly from the wind turbine to the power grid, but also halts energy flows should a calamity occur like a lightning strike. Also, at conventional onshore wind projects, these crucial switchgears occupy their own separate buildings connected to the turbines via cables. Nevertheless, at sea, that is not really an option. Due to this fact, engineers at GE mapped out a challenge of developing a switchgear powerful enough to run, but small enough to fit into the tower for themselves. The result is the so-called F-35, which at 2.4 meters high and 3.7 meters long, is a very impressive 30% smaller than earlier 66 kilowatt switchgears. Another possible solution on the predicament would be to use a lower voltage switchgear that is something in the 33 kilovolt range. But that would be mitigating the benefits of such a large turbine, which may not likely make it over to the land-based grid as a happy offshoot. The presented F-35 switchgear can currently be used on non-offshore and even non-wind farm applications, as it can comfortably fit under a city building. That's it on the world's biggest wind turbine. So, what do you think? Do you think this windmill farm is a great step in power generation? Do you think that the amount sunk into this project is worth it? Are you excited to learn more about this wind turbine and its upcoming projects? Let us know your impressions and views in the comment section below. If you liked this video and are a fan of mind-blowing, plush, and downright funny videos, stick around and observe what we have in store for you in our next video.